Hello friends, in my previous video I have already discussed about active low SR latch. So what is that? That is nothing but two NAND gate connected like this fashion, and S and R two inputs are there, and this was the truth table we got. If S equal to 1, R equal to 1, then the Q, that is normal output of the latch, will be the previous state only. Okay, that is denoted by Q of n plus 1, that is the present state, and Q of n is the previous state. So if S equal to 1, R equal to 1, then Q of n plus 1 is Qn. If S equal to 0, R equal to 1, then Q of n plus 1, that is next state, will be 1. If S equal to 1, R equal to 0, next state will be 0. If S equal to 0, R equal to 0, what happens? That Q and Q bar, that is normal output and inverted output, both becomes 1, which was making problem according to normal concept, that is normal form and complement form cannot be same. But when S equal to 0, R equal to 0 was there for this circuit, Q and Q bar was coming as same, so that we call them as forbidden region. We should not operate our SR latch in that region, right? Now the problem in this circuit was nothing but whenever I say, or whenever we say for a particular circuit, set that. Setting means making it 1. But when you are setting this, that is when you are making S equal to 1, what happens? That Q of n plus 1 becomes 0. Similarly, when we say reset the circuit, that means everything should be cleared. But when you are resetting, that is when R equal to 1, S equal to 0, Q of n plus 1, that is the next state, will become 1. That is, reset means 1, set means 0. This should not happen, right? But this was happening according to the circuit which we analyzed earlier. If you have not checked my previous video, please go through that, because if you know how to analyze this kind of circuits, then you will find this video very easy, okay? So basically, to avoid this problem, what scientists thought? Scientists thought, why not to add one inverter in the input side so that we can change the truth table, okay? So let us analyze the same circuit for just adding one inverter in the input side, okay? So this was our active low SR latch, and scientists modified to make active high SR latch. Scientists modified the circuit like this. Just what is the difference? Just one inverter is added in the input side. Now we should analyze this circuit, okay? So first case, let us take S equal to 1, R equal to 0. So suppose S equal to 1 and R equal to 0, so it will pass through the inverter. This becomes 1 becomes 0 and this 0 becomes 1. Okay, right? Now for NAND gate, if one input is 0, the output is surely going to be 1. It will not change anything else. Okay, so if for, as for NAND gate, one input is 0, the present output Q value will become 1, and this 1 will become basically fed back here for this NAND gate. And for the second NAND gate, see, both the inputs are 1, so that the Q bar will become 0. So see, as S equal to 1, R equal to 0, Q becomes 1 and Q bar becomes 0. Okay, so it is satisfying the normal condition, like Q and Q bar are complemented from, that is okay. And this follows the basic rule, that is whenever we are setting something, it should become 1. So see, when you are making S equal to 1, Q becomes 1. Okay. So this is following the normal convention, so it is okay. Now let us check for other cases. One case so far, S equal to 1, R equal to 0. Let us take the reverse case, S equal to 0, R equal to 1. So when S equal to 0, R equal to 1, what happens? When S equal to 0 and R equal to 1, when it will pass through the inverter, the output 0 will convert to 1 and this 1 of R will convert to 0. Now see, for the lower NAND gate, when one input is 0, it will not check the other input, it will make the output as 1. So Q bar becomes 1. As Q bar becomes 1, it will fade back here. And for the first NAND gate, see, now both the two inputs are basically 1. So for NAND gate, if two inputs, for two input NAND gate, if both the inputs are 1, no doubt output is going to be 0. So that the, if S equal to 0, R equal to 1, the next state, you can write as Q of n plus 1 also. So next state will become 0. Okay. So now see, again it is following the normal convention. When Q and Q bar are complemented from, yes, so there is no issue. There is no thinking of forbidden region concept. And moreover, When a is equal to 0, when you are making set as 0 and reset as 1, reset 1 means everything clear. So, the output is clear, Q becomes 0. Whatever output was previously, now Q becomes 0. So, it is following. Okay, fine. Now, let us check for other case. Suppose a is equal to 1, r equal to 1. Then what happens? If a is equal to 1 and r equal to 1, when it will pass through the inverter, it will become 0 and 0. And see, for the upper NAND gate, for 2 input NAND gate, if 1 input is 0, no doubt the output will become 1. So Q becomes 1. This one will feed back here. But here also, no need to think about feedback scheme, because from R as a inverted output, we are getting here 0, and for the second NAND gate also, if one input is 0, so no doubt the output will be 1. Now see, previously in active low SR latch, we were getting a forbidden region when A is equal to 0, R equal to 0. Now we are getting an A is equal to 1 and R equal to 1. Why? Because our Q and Q bar value become simultaneous to 1, which is not possible according to normal concept of digital electronics. Digital electronics says if Q is 1, Q bar must be 0. If Q is 0, Q bar must be 1. But here Q and Q bar both are 1 simultaneously. So, for this modified version of the circuit, we are getting forbidden region at A is equal to 1, R equal to 1. So, our three cases over, one is A is equal to 1, R equal to 1, one is A is equal to 0, R equal to 1, one is A is equal to 1, R equal to 0. Now, the last case is A is equal to 0, R equal to 0. Okay, so now see, what you just try to understand, if A is equal to 0, R equal to 0, when it will pass to the inverter, here it will become 1 and here also it will become 1. But if for 2 input NAND gate, 1 input is 1, we cannot say what will be the output. To determine the output, we must know the other input also. Like, you can just go through the table and you can easily understand. See, for the first 3 cases, as at least 1 input is 0, so we can say output is going to be 1. But if you consider, if 1 input is 1, then we cannot say what is the possible output. See here, you just consider you don't know the second input, you know only the first input. So see, first input for both the cases is 1. But for second, input here, this is 0, so it is giving 1. Here this is 1, it is giving 0. So that it also depends on the second input also. So we cannot directly comment. But for NAND gate, we can directly comment, if at least 1 input is 0, output must be 1. But we cannot say for the 1 combination. If at least 1 input is 1, what may be the possible output? We cannot say, because we should know the other input also, because the output will depend on the other input also, if 1 input is 1. Okay, so let us then assume some values. So, as I told you, Q of N is denoted to represent the earlier value of the output, and Q of N plus 1 is the present state. So suppose, as we have no opportunity, and say the NAND gate is connected to the Q, so that we can assume some previous value of Q. So suppose previous value of Q initially as 0. Let us check what happens. If Q of N is previously it was 0, then the 0 will come through this and 0 will come here. If A is equal to 0, R equal to 0 is there, so as a result, what will happen? That as R equal to 0, it will invert it and it will become 1. Now for second NAND gate, what is happening? One input is 0, other input is 1. So that no doubt Q bar is going to be what? 1. Because for NAND gate, if at least one input is 0, output should be 1. Now this Q bar, this is the present state of Q bar. This Q bar will flow through this path and here it will become 1. And as for the first NAND gate, you can see both the inputs are 1. Q of N plus 1, that is present state, is going to be 0. Okay, so if Qn is 0, we are getting by analyzing this circuit that Q of N plus 1 is also going to be 0. Now let us check for other case. Suppose, forget about our assumption. Let us assume that, let me erase this to avoid confusion. Okay, so now A is equal to 0, R equal to 0 is there, but let us assume Q of N as 1, that is previous state of the output as 1. If previous state of the output is 1, the 1 will flow through this path and 1 will come here. Now for the second NAND gate, both the inputs are 1. As both the inputs are 1, output will no doubt it will become what? 0. As present state of inverted output is 0, the 0 will flow through this path. 0 will come here. Now for the first NAND gate, one input is 1, other input is 0. So no doubt the present state of the normal output will become 1. Okay. So if previous state is 1, present state, that is Q of n plus 1, will also become 1. If previous state is 0, present state is also 0. So what is happening? If S equal to 0, R equal to 0 for this circuit, it will hold the previous state. That is, there is no change. Okay. So this is how you can analyze. Now you just conclude what is happening. If you summarize this, it was our previous, that is active low SR latch. Why we were telling so? Because when state equal to 1, when S becomes 1, Q of n plus 1 becomes 0. When reset equal to 1, Q of n plus 1 becomes 1. Okay, that is, it is not following the general convention. It is the reverse of the general convention. But see, for this circuit, what is the truth table? If S equal to 0, R equal to 0, Q of n plus 1 is Qn. That is no change. If state equal to 1, R equal to 0, Q of n plus 1 is set. That is, when you are setting something, it should set. It is following the normal convention. When reset equal to 1, state equal to 0, Q of n plus 1 is 0. That is, it is resetting the output. When S equal to 1, R equal to 1. See, here, as I discussed, when S equal to 1, R equal to 1, what happens? Both Q and Q are simultaneously become 1s, so that it is forbidden region. Okay, so that this is the truth table. Now see, if as this is active low, similarly, as this second circuit is performing the reverse of the active low, so we say this circuit is active high SR latch. And as I have shown you, the symbol to denote active low SR latch was S and R, and here two outputs, Q and Q bar. Okay, and as this was active low SR latch, so we have given one bubble in front of the active low SR latch. But as this is active high SR latch, because it is following the normal convention, so you can simply draw the block diagram of this active high SR latch as, or the symbolic representation of the active high SR latch as, directly as S as input, R as input, Q as output, Q bar as output. That is, there is no need to give the bubble because it is active high SR latch, okay? So these are the two types of SR latch widely used in practical scenarios. You must understand it very clearly. This is the base of sequential logic circuit. I hope these two truth tables are clear to you. Just try to understand. If you have any doubt, you can ask in the comment section. This is all for this video. In my next video, I will show other configuration of different latches. Thank you for watching.